Open your Bibles to Romans chapter 8.
Kõigepealt palun avaamaa piibel Rooma kirja 5. peatükist.
Romans chapter 8.
Kirja Roomastele 8. peatükist.
And we're on our fifth part in a series I've entitled Spirit.
Ja me oleme viiendas osas oma seerias, millele me oleme pannud pealkirjaks vaim.
Say spirit.
Ütle vaim.
Amen. We need him.
Meie vajame teda.
We want him in our life.
Me tahame teda oma ellu.
And so this teaching is about the Holy Spirit.
Ja see õpetus on pühast vaimust.
But he's the Spirit with many other names, and we've looked at that already.
Tema on siis vaim, kellel on väga palju erinevaid nimesid ja me oleme neid vaadanud natuke.
But the three words I really want to focus on who he is to us.
Aga need kolm sõna, mida ma tahan väga rõhutada, kes tema on meie jaoks.
He is God.
On see, et tema on Jumal.
He is our helper.
Tema on meie aitaja.
And he wants to be our very best friend.
Ja ta tahab olla meie kõige parem sõber.
Amen.
Amen.
So we've got to open up our lives to him.
Nii et me peame avama oma elut temale.
So before we get into the word of God this morning, let's just take a few moments and pray.
Nii et enne kui me läheme täna Jumala sõna juurde, võtame hetke aega ja paletame.
Father, we thank you for this time that we have together today.
Isa, me täname sind selle aja eest, mis meil täna siin koos on.
Lord, I thank you that your word is alive and it is powerful.
Isa, me täname sind selle eest, et sinu sõna on elav ja see on vägev.
And that this word speaks great things into our lives.
Et see sõna kõnetab vägevaid asju meie ellu.
So I pray, Holy Spirit, that you would just help each one in this place to open up their heart and life to you right now.
Püha vaim, ma palun, et aita igal inimesel täna siin avada oma süda ja elu sinu jaoks.
And I thank you that you help me.
Ja ma tänan, et sina aitad mind.
To speak just the way you would want me to speak.
Rääkida just sellisel viisil, nagu sina tahad, et ma räägin.
You are the teacher, Holy Spirit.
Sina oled õpetaja, püha vaim.
And so take these words of life.
Nii et võta need elusõnad.
And make it rivers of living water in this place.
Ja tee nii, et siin paigas oleks see elav vesi.
And I just thank you for your help.
Ja ma tänan sinu abi eest.
I thank you that you are here.
Ma tänan sind selle eest, et sina oled siin.
And we expect great things today as a church.
Ja me ootame täna vägevaid asju kogudusena.
In Jesus' wonderful name.
Jeesuse imelisel nimel.
Amen.
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 Well, we've been looking at the Holy Spirit.
Me oleme vaadanud püha vaimu.
And remember Jesus when he introduced the Holy Spirit.
Ja siis sa mäletad seda, et kui Jeesus tutvustas püha vaimu.
He did it very boldly, didn't he?
Siis ta tegi seda väga julgelt, on nii.
He was just like, man, he's coming and it's going to be so good for you.
Ta oli nii, et tema on et ta tuleb ja see on nii hea tee jaoks.
Jesus had excitement about going back to heaven and sending the Holy Spirit in a more real way for us.
Jeesus oli selline põnevus selles, et kui ta läheb sinna taevasse tagasi ja siis ta saadab selle püha vaimu meie jaoks.
Because something was going to happen that could never have happened before.
Kuna midagi sellist hakkas toimuma, mida mitte kunagi varem polnud juhtunud.
As Jesus by his blood was going to pay the price for sin.
Oli see, kus Jeesus oma verega maksab hinna patu eest.
And he would make us pure.
Ja tema teeb meid puhtaks.
So that the Spirit of God would not just come on us, but he could also come in us.
Nii et püha vaim lihtsalt ei tule meie üle, vaid ta saab ka meie sisse tulla.
And that's the most awesome thing that we could have as a help in life.
Ja see on kõige imelisem asi, mis meil saab olla abiks siin elus.
The Spirit of God that lives in you.
Jumala vaim, kes elab sinu sees.
Speaks to you.
Kõnetab sulle.
He will lead you and he will guide you in your life.
Ta juhib ja juhatab sind sinu elus.
He will give you wisdom.
Ta annab sulle tarkus.
He will help you.
Ta aitab sind.
Amen.
Amen.
I thank God for the fruits of the Spirit that will rise up from within us.
Ma tänan Jumalat nende vaimu viljade ees, mis tõusavad üles meie sees.
And we've looked at some of this over the past few weeks.
Ja me oleme vaadanud siin mõndasid siin viimaste nädalate jooksul.
But thank God.
Aga tänu Jumalale.
For the Holy Spirit who has come.
Püha vaimu eest, et kes on tulnud.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God.
Tänu Jumalale.
Thank God.
Tänu Jumalale.
Now when we talk about the Holy Spirit.
Kui meie räägime pühast vaimust.
You know, there's some people that always kind of just are like, whoa, I've heard some weird stuff about that.
Siis on olemas inimesi, kes on sellised väga nii, et vau, et kuule, ma olen kuulnud väga imelike asju selle kohta.
I'm not quite sure about that Holy Spirit thing, pastor.
Ma pole eriti kindel selle püha vaimu asja suhtes, pastor.
Let me just say this.
Las ma ütlen sulle seda.
The Holy Spirit is not weird.
Püha vaim ei ole imelik.
And he will not make you weird.
Ja tema ei tee sind imelikuks.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm so thankful for that.
Ma olen nii tänulik selle eest.
That if I become a Christian, I don't have to be weird.
Et see, et kui ma saan kristlaseks, siis ma ei pea olema imelik.
He will amplify.
Ta võimendab.
The goodness that God has put in you.
Seda headus, mille Jumal on sinu sisse pannud.
He will help anoint you and give you more ability.
Ta aitab siis anda võidmise sulle ja anda sulle rohkem võimet.
And he will make you better.
Ja ta teeb sind paremaks.
Not weirder.
Mitte imelikumaks.
Better.
Paremaks.
Amen.
Amen.
And so let's expect that. Let's believe God.
Nii et ootame seda, usume seda Jumalalt.
That we will continue to get better.
Et me jätkuvalt saame paremaks.
And the Holy Spirit is so important and so vital in our lives.
Ja püha vaim on nii tähtis. tähtis ja eluliselt vajalik meie eludes.
And this is the thing.
Ja asi on selles.
The devil has a strategy to attack the way we think about him.
Saatan on olemas selline strateegia, kuidas rünnata meid selles, kuidas me mõtleme tema kohta.
And he wants to mess people up in their thinking about the Holy Spirit.
Ja ta tahab tekitada inimestele sellise segaduse, kuna mõtlevad püha vaimu kohta.
But we want to know truth.
Aga meie tahame teada tõde.
Amen.
Amen.
We want to know what the Bible says about the Holy Spirit.
Me tahame teada seda, mida Piibel ütleb püha vaimu kohta.
And so that's why we're taking time to get into the word.
Ja sellepärast me võtame selle ja me läheme Jumala sõnasse.
That's why we put a focus and an emphasis on the word of God in this church.
Sellepärast me paneme fookuse ja sellise rõhu Jumala sõnale siin koguduses.
Because we want to know God.
Kuna meie tahame tunda Jumalat.
And when we know his word, we can know him.
Ja kui me tunneme tema sõna, siis me saame tunda teda.
And if you just read your Bible.
Ja kui sina lihtsalt loeksid oma piiblit.
And not listen to other people.
Ja sa ei kuulaks teisi inimesi.
But if you just read your Bible.
Vai kui sa oleksid lihtsalt lugenud oma piiblit.
You would see that the Holy Spirit is awesome.
Siis sa näeksid seda, et püha vaim on imeline.
You would have a great expectation for him.
Sul oleks selline suur ootus tema suhtes.
You would have a desire for him to show up in your life.
Sul oleks igatsus selles, et sa tahad, et ta ilmuks välja sinu elus.
And so you will want this.
Nii et sa tahaksid seda.
You'll want this help.
Nii et sa tahad seda abi.
You'll want this leading.
Et sa tahad seda juhtimist.
You'll want this power.
Sa tahad seda väge.
If we understand what it is.
Kui meie mõistame, mis see on.
We'll be able to put our faith out there and take steps.
Me oleme võimelised panema oma usu välja ja võtma sammu.
And walk in a greater measure in the Spirit of God.
Ja kõndima suuremas mõõdus Jumala vaimust juhituna.
We could live at a higher level spiritually than what we are right now.
Me saame elada siis vaimselt palju kõrgemal tasemel, kui me elame praegu.
When we get revelation on how awesome the Spirit of God is.
Kui me saame ilmutuse sellest, kui imeline on Jumala püha vaim.
And so the Holy Spirit is a great help in life.
Nii et püha vaim on väga suur abi elus.
He's a help for us in our prayer.
Ta on abi meie jaoks palves.
We talked about last week how he'll even give you a language that you could speak directly to your Heavenly Father.
See nädal rääkisime sellest, kus ta annab sulle taevase keele, kus sa saad otse rääkida oma taevase isaga.
The secret language that's just between you and your God.
Sellise salakeele, mis on lihtsalt sinu ja Jumala vahele.
And this is where we just pray out the future plan of God for us and for others.
Ja see on see paik, kus kohas me paletame välja need tuleviku plaane meie enda jaoks, aga teiste jaoks.
Now we pray in the spirit.
Et me paletame vaimus.
For what God wants to do on the earth.
Selles, mida, seda, selle kohta, mida Jumal tahab, et me siin maa peal teeksime.
And the Bible says that we pray out mysteries.
Ja Piibel räägib, et me paletame välja saladusi.
Things that have been hidden.
Neid asju, mis on olnud peidetud.
So that our enemy, the devil, cannot stop it.
Nii et meie vaenlane saatan ei saaks peatada.
Amen.
Amen.
And remember, Jesus said this.
Ja mäletage seda, Jeesus ütles nii.
He said, all of hell.
Ta ütles, et kogu põrgu.
Cannot stop the plan of God.
Ei saa peatada Jumala plaani.
Amen.
Amen.
Glory to God. The church is victorious.
Kogudus on võidukas.
And we need to walk in that victory.
Ja me peame kõndima selles võidus.
We need to live in that victory.
Me peame elama selles võidus.
You are that victory.
Sina oled see võit.
Amen.
Amen.
I'm the church. You're the church.
Mina olen kogudus. Sina oled kogudus.
It's not about a building.
Et asja ei ole hoone.
It's about people.
Vaid asja on inimeste.
Temple of the Most High God.
Kõik väelis Jumala templid.
And we are to go out and represent him right in the world that we visit every day.
Ja me peaksime minema välja esindama teda õigest igal päeval, kui me läheme ja käime seal.
And so we can pray out the plans and the purposes of God.
Nii et me saame välja paletada Jumala plaane ja eesmärke.
With the help of the Holy Spirit.
Püha vaimu abiga.
And so in life.
Nii et elus.
You know, there's so much that we need.
On olemas nii paljusid asju, mida meie vajame.
You know, and we talk about different principles.
Me rääksime erinevatest printsiipidest.
When you come to church, you're going to learn biblical truths.
Kui sina tuled siia kogudusse, siis õpid piibelike tõdesid.
You're going to learn how to put things in the right place in your life.
Sa õpid seda, kuidas panna asju õigesse kohta oma elus.
And you could learn about all the principles of faith.
Ja sa saad õppida kõike usu printsiipe.
But still be a failure.
Aga ikkagi olla läbi kukkuja.
You can learn all the what the Bible says about prayer.
Sa võid õppida kõike seda, mida Piibel ütleb palve kohta.
And still not get your prayer answered.
Ja ikkagi mitte saada oma palvetele vastuseid.
You can learn all about the authority that you have in the name of Jesus.
Sa võid õppida kõigest sellest meelevallast, mis sulle kuulub Jeesuse nimes.
And still be defeated in life.
Ja ikkagi olla siis selline kaotusosaline siin elus.
So it's not just about what you know.
Nii et asja ei ole lihtsalt selles, mida sa tead.
It's about how you use what you know.
Vaid selles, kuidas sa kasutad seda, mida sa juba tead.
And you have to be led by the Spirit of God.
Sa pead olema juhitud Jumala vaimu poolt.
In all these things that we teach.
Kõikides neis asjades, mida me õpetame.
In all the things that you learn.
Ja kõikides neis asjades, mida sa õpid.
In all the things of God.
Ja kõikides Jumala asjades.
You have to be led by the Holy Spirit on how it comes out and how it affects you.
Sina pead olema juhitud püha vaimu poolt, et selles, et kuidas see tuleb ilmsiks ja kuidas see saab toimima sinu elus.
And if we try to do any of these things just in our own strength.
Ja kui me proovime neid asju teha lihtsalt enda jõust.
If we just try to do it with our own understanding.
Kui me lihtsalt proovime teha seda enda arusaamisega.
We're going to fall short. We're going to miss the target.
Siis me ei jää puudu, siis me paneme mööda sellest märgist.
We're not going to be all that God wants us to be.
Siis me ei saa olla kõike seda, mida Jumal tahab, et me oleksime.
We need to be led by the Holy Spirit of God.
Me peame olema juhitud Jumala püha vaimu poolt.
To have the success in every area of our lives.
Selleks, et meil saaks olla edu kõigis meie elu valdkondades.
Because God does want you to be a success.
Kuna Jumal tahab, et sina oleksid edukas.
He did all of this.
Ta tegi kõik selle.
Jesus died.
Jeesus suri.
The Spirit of God was sent for us.
Jumala püha vaim saadeti meie jaoks.
So that we would be effective and have success in life.
Et me saaksime olla edukad ja meil saaks olla edu siin elus.
Amen.
Amen.
Thank God.
Tänu Jumala.
You should wake up every day thankful.
Sa peaksid ärkama igal hommikul olles tänulik.
Amen.
Amen.
And thankful people are happy people.
Ja tänulikud inimesed on õnnelikud inimesed.
Amen.
Amen.
And so we should live our lives happy.
Nii et me peaksime elama oma elusid õnnelikena.
Not because of what you know, something happened on that day.
Mitte sellepärast, mis midagi juhtus sellel päeval.
But something that happened 2000 years ago.
Vaid midagi sellise pärast, mis toimus 2000 aastat tagasi.
Makes us happy every day.
See teeb meid õnnelikuks iga päev.
Amen. And so this is what we have.
Nii et see on see, mis meil on.
And so I want to talk about the Holy Spirit today as we kind of conclude this series.
Ma tahan rääkida täna siis pühast vaimust, kui me nüüd siis hakkame lõpetama seda seeriat.
And I want to talk about him being the one who should lead us in our life.
Ma tahan rääkida sellest, et temas kui kellegis, kes peaks olema see, kes juhib meid meie eludes.
You need to know that you could trust him in his leading.
Ja sa peaksid teama seda, et sa saad usaldada tema juhtimises.
And whether you believe this or not, you need him to lead you.
Kas sina tead seda või sa ei tea, sa vajad, et ta juhiks sind.
If he is not leading you, if you're not looking to him for direction.
Kui tema juhi sind, kui sina ei otsi temalt suunda.
Then you are missing so much in your life.
Siis sa jääd nii väga paljust ilma oma elus.
And you might think your life is going okay.
Sa võid mõelda seda, et teab, mu elu läheb täiesti okay.
But if you would follow the leading of the Holy Spirit,
aga kui sina ei järgned Jumala püha vaimu juhtimisele,
your life would be amazing.
Siis sinu elu oleks imeline.
I don't want to die and say my life was okay.
Ma ei taha surra ja öelda, et tead, et mu elu oli päris siuke enam vähem.
I want to die saying my life was amazing.
Ma tahan surra sellisel viisil, et ma saan öelda, et mu elu oli lihtsalt imeline.
Amen.
Amen.
And we can do that.
Ja me saame teha seda.
If we'll follow the leading of the Holy Spirit of God.
Kui me järgneme Jumala püha vaimu juhtimisele.
So here in Romans chapter 8, we're going to be in Romans for a good part of this day.
Ja siin nüüd Rooma kirja 8. Peatüki enamus osa sellest päevast me oleme seal peatükis.
But Romans chapter 8 verse 14 says this.
Aga Rooma kirja 8. Peatüki 14.
Because those that are led by the Spirit of God, they are the sons of God.
Sest kõik, keda iganes Jumala vaim juhib, on Jumala lapsed.
So we could say this.
Et me saame öelda seda.
The children of God are led by the Spirit of God.
Jumala lapsed on juhitud Jumala vaimu poolt.
Amen.
Amen.
The children of God are led by the Spirit of God.
Jumala lapsed on juhitud Jumala vaimu poolt.
How many have made Jesus your Lord and Savior?
Kui paljud teist on teinud Jeesust oma isanda ja päästja?
Then you're a child of God.
Siis sina oled Jumala laps.
And you should be led by God.
Ja sina peaksid olema juhitud Jumala poolt.
And so everyone is going to be led by something.
Nii et igaüks on juhitud millegi poolt.
Everybody's going to be led by something.
Igaüks saab olema juhitud millegi poolt.
You're going to be led by your emotions.
Sa oled juhitud kas oma emotsioonidest.
You're going to be led by your head.
Kas oma pea poolt.
You're going to be led by circumstances.
Sa oled juhitud oma olukordade poolt.
You're going to be led by opportunities.
Sa oled juhitud siis sa kas siis oled juhitud oma võimaluste poolt.
You're going to be led by something in every decision you make.
Sa saad olema juhitud millegi poolt igas otsuses mida sa teed.
And God is wanting us to know.
Ja Jumal tahab et me teaksime.
He wants to be the one to help us.
Et tema tahab olla see, kes tahab aidata meid.
Don't be led by your head, your emotions, the circumstances.
Ära ole juhitud oma peast, emotsioonidest, olukordadest.
Do not be led just because there's an opportunity.
Ära ole juhitud lihtsalt sellepärast, et avaneb võimalus, et seal on olemas võimalus.
Well, there was a job offer for me to go to Siberia, so I guess I'm going to go there.
Oli selline tööpakkumine Siberisse, nii et ma siis vist nüüd lähen sinna.
If God hasn't called you to Siberia, don't go.
Kui Jumal ei ole kutsunud sind Siberisse, siis ära mine sinna.
Oh, there's a job offer for me to go to America.
Aga on olemas tööpakkumine minna Ameerikasse töötama.
If it's not God's call for you to go to America, don't go.
Kui see ei ole Jumala kutse minna Ameerikasse, siis ära mine.
Amen.
Amen.
It's not just an opportunity that should lead us, it's the Spirit of God that should lead us.
See, on lihtsalt see võimalus, mis peaks meid juhtima, vaid Jumala vaim peaks meid juhtima.
And so if we're led by anything else than the Holy Spirit,
kui me oleme juhitud millegi muu poolt kui püha vaimu poolt,
we're going to miss so much in this life.
Me jääme ilma nii palju siin elus.
And so we need to be spirit led.
Nii et me peame olema vaimu poolt juhitud.
This is something we're on the inside.
See midagi sellist, mis on sees.
The Holy Spirit speaks to your spirit.
Püha vaim kõnetab sinu vaimu.
And then the Holy Spirit is speaking to your heart.
Ja püha vaim kõnetab sinu südant.
And letting you know where to go and what to do.
Andes sulle teada, kuhu minna ja mida teha.
Don't just be listening to voices to come out of the sky.
Ära lihtsalt kuula neid hääli, mis tulevad kuskilt taevast.
Listen to the voice of God in your heart.
Et kuula seda Jumala häält oma südames.
Because as we've already looked at in this series, you are the temple of the Most High God.
Kuna me oleme vaadanud siin seeres seda juba, et sina oled Jumala püha vaimu tempel.
He's in you and he will speak to you on the inside.
Et tema on sinu sees ja ta kõnetab sind sinu sees pool.
We just need to learn to recognize his voice and to follow his leading.
Me lihtsalt peame õppima ära tundma tema hääle ja järgnema tema juhtimisele.
Let me tell you, it's something you have to learn to do.
Ja las ma ütlen sulle, et see on midagi sellist, mida sa pead õppima tegema.
It's not something we're trying.
See ei ole midagi sellist, mida me üritame teha.
Something that we're training to do.
Vaid midagi sellist, mille jaoks me ennast treenime, et seda teha.
Anybody ever heard anything about trying and training?
Kas keegi on kunagi kuulnud midagi üritamisest ja treenimisest?
All right, we talked about that in the series during the summer.
Me rääkisime sellest seerias, mis oli suvel.
We are not trying to live a Christian life.
Et me ürita elada kuidagi kristlase elu.
Because if you're just trying something and you can't do it, you'll quit.
Sellepärast, kui sa lihtsalt midagi üritad midagi ja sa ei saa hakkama, siis sa annad alla.
But we're training.
Aga vaid me treenime ennast.
It's a lifelong effort.
See on selline kogu elu kestev pingutus.
We're training to get better and better at following the Spirit of God as he leads us.
Et me treenime ennast, et saada tugevamaks ja tugevamaks püha vaimu järgimisel siin elus.
You need to know that when he leads you, you can trust him 100%.
Ja ma tahan sulle öelda seda, et kui tema juhib sind, sa võid usaldada teda 100%.
Even if it looks tough.
Isegi kui see paistab raskena.
Even if it looks impossible.
Isegi kui see asi paistab võimatuna.
If you trust God,
kui sina usaldad Jumalat,
nothing is impossible.
Siis mitte midagi ei ole, siis mingi asi ei ole võimatu.
Amen.
Amen.
Not one amen.
Mitte ühtegi aamenit.
If you trust God,
kui sina usaldad Jumalat,
anything is possible.
Siis kõik asjad on võimalikud.
Amen.
Amen.
Why?
Mille pärast?
Because he said.
Sellepärast, et tema ütles.
If the Bible is God's word.
Kui Piibel on Jumala sõna.
And the Bible is true.
Ja Piibel on tõde.
And God said nothing is impossible for me.
Ja Jumal ütles, et mitte midagi ei ole võimatud minu jaoks.
We either choose to believe this is God's word or not.
Siis me peame tegema valiku, et kas see nüüd on Jumala sõna või see ei ole.
I believe.
Et ma usun.
Nothing's impossible.
Et mitte miski ei ole võimatud.
So even though it might look dark and it might look like I'm stuck.
Ja kuigi see võib näida sellise väga kuidagi tumedana ja suuke tunne, et ma olen kuidagi kinni jäänud.
I've seen God time and time again pull me out of a hole I was in and set my feet back on a rock and help me to run.
Ma olen näinud väga paljusid kordi, kus Jumal on haaranud minus kinni siis, kui ma olen olnud mingis tumedas august, on mitselt välja tõmmanud ja pannud mu jalad kindlale kaljule, siis ma olen julgelt edasi läinud.
Amen.
Amen.
And so you don't need to have all the answers to obey God.
Nii et sul ei pea olema kõik need vastused selle jaoks, et kuuletuda Jumalale.
You don't need to know everything that's going to happen before you take a step of faith.
Sa ei pea teadma kõike seda, mis saab toimuma enne, kui sina võtad sammu.
But as the Holy Spirit leads you,
aga kui püha vaim juhib sind,
take that step of faith and say, all right, God, I trust that you're going to help me out of this.
Siis võtas usu samm ja ütle, et Jumala, ma usaldan sind, et sina aitab mind sellest välja läbi.
You know, in Proverbs chapter 14, verse 12, it says this.
Õpetussõnad 14:12 ütleb seda.
There is a way that seems right to a man.
Mehe meelest on mõnigi tee õige.
But in the end, it leads to death.
Aga lõpuks on see surma tee.
So this is something God spoke in the Old Testament.
See on midagi sellist, mida Jumal rääkis vanast testamendist.
Wisdom by the Holy Spirit.
Selle tarkuse läbi, mis on siis sellest tarkuse, mis tuli püha vaimu läbi.
And so what it's saying here is there's a difference between man's way or your way and God's way.
Siin on see, et siin ütleb seda, et on olemas erinevus inimese tarkuse ja Jumala tarkuse vahel, inimese tee vahel ja Jumala tee vahel.
There's a difference in God's plan for your life and your plan for your life.
On olemas erinevus Jumala plaani on olemas erinevus siis Jumala plaani suhtes ja sinu plaani suhtes sinu elu jaoks.
Amen.
Amen.
I am so glad.
Ma olen nii tänulik selle
eest. God's plan for my life was different than my plan for my life.
Et Jumala plaan minu elu jaoks on teistsugune kui minu enda plaan.
My plan failed.
Minu enda plaan see kukkus läbi.
My plan was a mess.
Minu plaan oli selline paras segadus.
And I couldn't be who who I even wanted to be.
Ja ma ei saanud olla see, ma ei saanud olla isegi see, keda ma tahtsin ennast, et ma oleks.
And then when I gave my life to the Lord, he said, all right, now, this is your plan.
Ja siis kui ma andsin oma elu isandale, siis tema ütles, et vot see on sinu plaan.
A total different life.
Täielikult teistmoodi elu.
But one that I am so thankful for.
Aga selline elu, mille eest ma olen nii tänulik.
Now, you might not be called to go pastor a church somewhere.
Sa võibolla pole kutsutud, et minna ei olla kuskil pastoriks kogudusele.
But his plan for your life is going to be a lot better than your plan.
Aga sinu plaan, aga tema plaan sinu elu jaoks saab olema palju parem kui su enda plaan su elu jaoks.
You need to know his ways best for you.
Ja me peame teadma seda, et tema plaan on parim sinu jaoks.
I want to read Romans chapter 8. I'm going to read from verse 6 here.
Rooma kiri
8.
peatükk ja 6. salm.
And I want to read this just out of the New Living Translation, so just repeat after me.
Ja ma loen selle siis New Living tõlkest.
It says letting your sinful man
lastes oma patusele inimesele
control your mind
loomusel kontrollida oma meelt
leads to death
see viib surma
but letting the spirit
aga kui sa lased vaimul lastes vaimul
control your mind
kontrollida oma meeli
it leads to life and peace
siis see viib ellu ja rahusse.
So if you're letting your fleshly desires control the way that you think
kui sina lased oma lihalikel himudel kontrollida seda viisi kuidas sa mõtled
your way
sinu viisi
is going to lead to death
siis sinu viis viib surma.
But if you will live a life led by the Spirit,
aga kui sina elad oma elu juhituna püha vaimu poolt,
if you'll let the Spirit help you to think right,
kui sina aitad vaimul mõelda õigesti,
you'll have two awesome things.
Kui sina lased vaimul aidata sul mõelda õigesti, siis sul on olemas kaks imelist asja.
Life,
elu,
and this is the good life.
Ja see on selline hea elu.
This is a blessed life.
See on õnnistatud elu.
This is the life that Jesus paid for us to have.
See on see elu, mille eest Jeesus maksis hinna, et meil saaks
olla.
He said
life to the full.
Ta ütles, et elu ülevoolavalt.
It's overflowing.
Üleküllustlikult kuni seda on ülevoolavalt.
Amen. That's the life that we can have.
See on see elu, mis meil saab olla.
And in that life,
ja selles elus,
we'll have peace.
Meil on rahu.
Those are two awesome things.
Need on need kaks imelist asja.
Amen. If you could enjoy your life,
kui sa saad nautida oma elu,
and if you could have peace in your heart and in your mind,
ja sul saab olla rahu südames ja meeltes,
life is good.
Siis elu on hea.
Amen.
Amen.
If you lose any of that,
kui sa kaotad midagi seda sellist,
life can get tough.
Siis elu võib minna väga raskeks.
And if life is tough for you this morning, I encourage you, get back to God.
Ja kui täna hommikul on elu raske sinu jaoks, ma julgustan sind, mine tagasi Jumala juurde.
Get back to that place where you can hear from the Holy Spirit.
Mine tagasi sinna paika, kus kohas sa saad kuulda püha vaimu käest.
So if we follow God's way,
need kui me järgneme Jumala viisile,
we will know true life and true peace.
Siis me saame tundma tõelist elu ja tõelist rahu.
And he wants to reveal those things to us by his Holy Spirit.
Ja ta tahab meile ilmutada neid asju läbi oma püha vaimu.
Now, if you would come to me and say this.
Kui sina tuleksid minu juurde ütleksid nii.
Well, pastor, I am not led by the Holy Spirit.
Pastor, ma ei ole juhitud püha vaimu poolt.
I've tried.
Ma olen proovinud.
And he just does not lead me.
Aga ta lihtsalt ei juhi mind.
The Bible says,
Piibel ütleb,
we just read it here,
me just lugesime siin,
that all the children of God are led by the Spirit of God.
Et kõik Jumala lapsed on juhitud Jumala vaimu poolt.
And so if you would come to me and say, I'm not led by the Holy Spirit.
Ja kui sina tuleksid minu juurde ütleksid, et ma ei ole juhitud püha vaimu poolt.
Something is wrong.
Siis midagi on valesti.
And something needs to change.
Ja miski peab muutuma.
Let me just tell you what's not changing.
Ja las ma sulle ütlen, et mis asi ei muutu.
God and his word.
Jumal ja tema sõna.
Amen. That's not Amen. Changing.
Need ei muutu.
And so if you're not being led,
nii et kui sina ei ole juhitud,
who needs to change?
Siis kes peab muutuma?
You.
Sina.
Because God and his word aren't.
Kuna Jumal ja tema sõna, need ei muutu.
And so if we're not being led by God like we see that we can be,
kui me ei ole juhitud Jumala vaimu poolt nii, nagu me näeme, et see peaks olema,
then we need to change. We need to make the adjustments.
Siis meie peame muutuma, meie peame tegema korrigeeringud.
This is the way that God wants us to live our lives.
See on see viis, kuidas Jumal tahab, et me elaksime oma elus.
He will lead us and he will guide us.
Ta juhib ja ta juhatab meid.
And again, I don't want to just play church.
Aga jällegi, et ma lihtsalt ei taha kuidagi mängida kogudust.
If we're just playing church, I'm not going to show up next week.
Kui me lihtsalt mängime kogudus, siis ma järgmine nädal ei tule kohale.
Right? I don't want you to show up.
Ma ei taha, et sina tuleksid kohale.
I want us to be sincere about this relationship with God.
Vaid ma tahan, et me oleksime siirad selles suhtes Jumalaga.
And believe God, his word is true over everything.
Ja usuksime Jumalat seda, et tema sõna on tõde üle iga asja.
Because if it's not,
sellepärast, kui see ei ole,
we're all just brainwashed and confused.
Siis me oleme kõik lihtsalt, meil on tehtud ajupesu ja me oleme segaduses.
Right? Isn't that? Would that be true?
Kas see oleks tõde siis?
I'm not brainwashed.
Minu aju ei ole kuidagi ära pestud.
And I'm not confused.
Ja ma ei ole segaduses.
Amen. Amen. I know exactly what I do and I know exactly why I do it.
Ma tean täpselt, mida ma teen ja mille jaoks ma teen.
And it's all based on the foundation that I trust and I believe his word is true.
Ja see kõik põhineb sellele vundamendile, et ma tean ja usaldan teda selles, et tema sõna on tõde.
And he will speak to his children by his spirit.
Ja ta kõnetab oma lapsi läbi oma vaimu.
And so if you were not hearing from God.
Et kui sina ei kuule Jumala käest.
If you would tell me I don't hear from God.
Kui sa ütleksid mulle, et tead, ma ei kuule Jumalat.
Then you need to make the adjustment.
Siis sina pead tegema korrigeeringud.
You know, it's like a radio.
Tead, see on täpselt nagu raadio.
God is transmitting constantly.
Jumal pidevalt saadab siis neid kogu aeg saadab siis sõnumeid.
He's trying to lead you. He's trying to get his way in your life.
Ta proovib juhtida sind, ta proovib saada siis oma viise sinu ellu.
He wants you to live a better life.
Ta tahab seda, et sa elaksid paremat elu.
And so he's transmitting by his Holy Spirit to your spirit.
Nii et tema siis teeb kogu aeg saadab edastab kogu aeg oma vaimust sinu vaimu.
Now, if we're not listen, if we can't get the radio signal, what do?
Kui me ei saa seda raadiosignaali sealt kätte, siis mida me teeme?
We adjust.
Siis me reguleerime seda.
We tune it.
Me see reguleerime seda, keerame selle sageduse paika.
That's the way we need to do with our spirit.
Ja samamoodi peame tegema ka oma vaimuga.
If God's talking and he is,
kui Jumal räägib ja ta teeb seda,
make the adjustment.
Siis tee need vajalikud korrigeeringud.
Say, all right, God, I'm not hearing from you, Holy Spirit, I need this.
Ja ütle, et Jumal, ma ei kuule sinu käest, et püha vaim, ma vajan seda.
I need your wisdom.
Ma vajan sinu tarkust.
I need to know what to do today.
Ma vajan teada seda, mida täna teha.
And I'm going to take some time and I'm going to just be in your presence because I want to hear from you.
Ma võtan selle aja, ma tahan olla sinu ligiolus ja ma olen sinu ligiolus, kuna ma tahan kuulda sinu käest.
Make that a priority of your life.
Tee see prioriteediks oma elus.
And if you can hear from God, he will bless everything you put your hand.
Ja kui sa saad kuulda Jumalat, siis ta õnnistab sind kõiges, mille külges oma käed paned.
And it would be stupid of us.
Ja see oleks väga loll meie poolt.
To think just because we have not heard from God.
Mõelda nii, et kui me ei ole kuulnud Jumala, lihtsalt mõelda nii, et kui me ei kuule Jumala käest.
That it does not work and God is not speaking.
Siis see ei toimi ja Jumal ei räägi.
It would be foolish of you.
See oleks väga rumal sinu poolt.
To be so narrow-minded.
Olla nii väga selline kuidagi, et sa vaatad nii kitsanurgaliselt.
To say if God can't talk to me the way that I am, then forget it.
Kui Jumal ei saa rääkida mulle sellisel viisil, nagu mina olen, siis unustage ära kõik.
Don't be a fool.
Et ära ole rumal.
Don't live that way.
Ära ela sellise viisil.
If that's been your thinking, get that out of your head.
Kui see on olnud sinu mõtte viis, siis saa see ära oma peast.
And you need to say, God, show me how I can hear from you.
Sa peaksid ütlema Jumala, et Jumal näita mulle, kuidas ma saan kuulda sinu käest.
I need you, I want you in my life.
Ma vajan sind, ma tahan sind oma ellu.
And so if you don't hear him clearly, make the adjustments that you need to make.
Kui sina ei kuule teda selgesti, siis tee need vajalikud korrigeeringud, mida on vaja teha.
And you will be able to hear from God.
Ja siis sa oled võimeline kuulma Jumala käest.
Now when I say hearing from God.
Ja nüüd kui ma räägin siin Jumala kuulmisest.
Let me just make this clear again.
Las ma teen selle jälle selgeks.
I'm not talking about hearing voices.
Ma ei räägi sellest, et sa kuuled hääli.
I'm not talking about hearing anything with your natural ears.
Sellest, et sa kuuled midagi oma loomulike kõrvadega.
I'm talking about hearing God with the ears of your heart.
Või ma räägin sellest, et sa kuuled Jumalat oma südame kõrvadega.
Because he could speak to you in a way where nobody else hears, but you hear clearly.
Kuna tema saab kõnetada sind sellisel viisil, kus mitte keegi teine ei kuule seda, aga sina kuuled teda väga selgesti.
And there's this internal conversation that you're having all the time.
On olemas selline seesmine vestlus, mis sul on kogu aeg olemas su sees.
You know? And some of you have a greater internal conversation than others.
Ja mõndadel on see seesmine vestlus suurem kui kellelgi muul. Kui teistel võib olla.
A lot of times when you're listening to a message like this, you're talking to yourself on the inside the whole time. Yeah, I need to do that. Well, I better hurry up and do that. If I don't change that, I'm going to be a mess.
Väga tihti on nii, et kui sa kuuled niimoodi sarnast sõnumit, siis su sees käib selline vestus, siis ja vestus, et okei, okay, et jah, et ma pean tegema seda, et ma pean seda muutma. Ja
yeah, okay, and I think the Holy Spirit takes these words and he amplifies them to you.
Ja ma mõtlen seda, püha vaim võtab need sõnad ja ta võimendab need sulle.
He speaks to your heart.
Ta kõnetab sinu südamesse.
And you're getting things that others aren't even getting.
Ja sina saad asju, mida teised isegi ei saa.
Because of that internal conversation.
Selle seesmise vestluse tõttu.
That's how he's going to speak to you.
See on see viis, kuidas tema kõnetab sinu.
So don't start listening for voices.
Nii et ära siis hakka otsima häälte kuulmist.
Listen to your heart.
Vaid kuule oma südant.
Listen to what it is that God is speaking to you by his spirit.
Kuula seda, mida Jumal räägib sulle läbi oma vaimu.
Learn to be sensitive to that leading and to that guiding.
Õppi olema tundlik selle juhtimisele ja juhatamisele.
And that's where God is going to speak to you.
Ja see on see paik, kus Jumal kõnetab sind.
And you might say, how?
Sa võid küsida, kuidas?
Look here at Romans chapter 8 verse 16.
Vaata siia nüüd Rooman kirja 8. peatükk 16. salm.
It says in the spirit himself testifies with our spirit that we are God's children.
See sama vaim tunnistab koos meie vaimuga, et me oleme Jumala lapsed.
The spirit of God testifies with our spirit.
Jumala vaim tunnistab koos meie vaimuga.
That's how God speaks to you.
See on see viis, kuidas Jumal kõnetab sind.
Not a voice in your head, it's a voice in your heart.
See ei ole hääl sinu peas, vaid see on hääl sinu südames.
Amen.
Amen.
And really, that's what we've got to distinguish between.
Ja tegelikult see on see, mille vahel me siis peame niimoodi valima.
Is the thing I'm thinking about, is it just my head or has this come from my heart?
See asi, mille peale mõtlen, et kas see tuleb lihtsalt mu pea, kas see on lihtsalt mu peas või tuleb see mu südamest?
Is this just me or is this God?
On see lihtsalt mina või on see Jumal?
Have you ever had that question before?
Kas sul kunagi on varem olnud sellist küsimust?
I have.
Mul on olnud.
Is this my idea or is this God's idea?
Kas see minu idee või on see Jumala idee?
And the Bible says the thing that will divide that is when we get into the word and we feed on God's word.
Ja Piibel ütleb, et see asi, mis siis selle niimoodi nagu eristab ja teeb selgeks, on see, et me läheme Jumala sõnasse ja me toitume Jumala sõnast.
And so it's not a voice in our head, it's that inner voice in our heart.
Et see ei ole meie selline pea hääl, vaid see on selline meie seesmine hääl.
It's that spiritual impression.
See on selline vaimne väljendus.
That little nudge on the inside, gentle nudge.
Selline väike, selline õrn, selline puudutus sinu sees.
Or that just knowing.
Või siis lihtsalt selline teadmine.
It's just a knowing on the inside what to do in this situation.
Et sa tead oma sees, oma südames, mis on, kuidas käituda selles olukorras.
And let that override anything else.
Ja lasse siis olla siis üle kõige, lasse olla selline kõige olulisem asi sinu jaoks.
And I think this.
Ja ma mõtlen nii.
I think even if you have figured out the way that you are to do something.
Ma mõtlen seda, et kui sa oled isegi juba välja mõelnud, kuidas mingit asja teha.
And it, you know, it seems good to you.
Ja see tundub hea sinu jaoks.
The Bible says there's a way that seems right and it leads to death.
Piibel ütleb, et on olemas selline tee, mis tundub õige, aga see viib surma.
Just check it with the Holy Spirit first.
Siis lihtsalt kontrolli seda püha vaimu käest.
Every decision I make, especially the big decisions.
Iga otsus, mida ma teen, eriti selliste suurte otsuste juures.
I want to go slow.
On see, et ma tahan minna aeglaselt.
I want to make sure I'm hearing from God.
Ma tahan teha kindlaks, et ma kuulen Jumala käest.
So what I'm going to do is I'm going to sit on that idea or that thought.
Mis on siis see, et ma istun selle mõtte või selle ideega.
That plan.
Selle plaaniga.
I'm just going to let that sit.
Ma lihtsalt lasen selle istuda oma sees.
And I'm going to check my heart to see do I have peace or not.
Ja ma kontrollin oma südame läbi, et kas mul on rahu selle suhtes või ei ole.
The Bible says that he'll lead us with peace.
Kuna Piibel ütleb, et tema juhib meid läbi rahu.
And so I want to make sure that I have peace in my heart.
Nii et ma tahan olla kindel, kindlaks teab, mul on rahu minu südames.
So you always need to check.
Nii et sa alati pead kontrollima.
Even if you think you've got it figured out.
Isegi siis, kui sa mõtled, et sa oled asjale täpselt pihta saanud.
God, do I have peace? Are you with me in this? Because I don't want to do it on my own.
Jumal, kas mul on rahu, et kas sina oled koos minuga selles, et ma ei taha ise üksinda teha?
And I think many Christians actually ignore the leading of the Holy Spirit.
Ja ma mõtlen seda, et väga palju kristlased nad lihtsalt ignoreerivad püha vaimu juhtimist.
And then they wonder, you know, why did that happen?
Ja siis nad imestavad, mille pärast see juhtus?
And other people that watch their life are thinking, why did that happen to them? They're such a nice guy.
Ja teised inimesed, kes näevad enda elu vaata, mõtled, miks see juhtus nendega, nad on ju nii kenad inimesed.
But the truth is this, God is doing his part all the time.
Aga tõde on see, et Jumal teeb enda osa kogu aeg.
God's trying to get his plan to you.
Jumal proovib saada oma plaani sulle.
He wants you to hear from him.
Ta tahab seda, et sina kuuleksid teda.
We just need to listen.
Meie lihtsalt peame kuulama.
We need to make that a priority that I want to know on the inside that I'm doing what God wants me to do.
Me peame tegema sellest prioriteedi, et ma tahan kuulda enda sees seda, mida Jumal tahab, et ma teeksin.
And if it's a wrong choice,
ja kui see on vale valik,
you're going to find some resistance.
Siis sa leiad sellist vastuseisu.
And if you ignore that inward witness,
ja kui sina siis ignoreerid seda seesmist tunnistust,
it's going to end up with trouble.
Siis see asi viib sinna paika, kus kohas sul tekivad raskused ja probleemid.
Have you ever made this statement about yourself and about your life?
Kas sa kunagi oled enda ja oma elu kohta öelnud nii?
I knew I shouldn't have done that.
Ma tean, et ma oleksin pidanud seda tegema.
I should not have done that.
Ma tean, et ma poleks pidanud seda tegema.
I knew I shouldn't have gone out with that guy.
Ma tean, et ma poleks pidanud välja minema selle mehega.
I knew I shouldn't have gone there.
Ma tean, et ma poleks pidanud sinna minema.
I knew I shouldn't have said those things.
Ma tean, et ma poleks pidanud ütlema neid asju.
But what did we do?
Aga mida meie tegime?
We did it anyway.
Me ikkagi tegime seda.
All right. What is that knowing?
Mis on se teadmine?
That's God trying to stop you from making a mistake.
See on see, kus Jumal proovib sind peatada tegemast viga.
He's trying to protect you. He's trying to guard your life.
Ta proovib kaitsta sind, ta proovib kaitsta sinu elu.
And we've got to learn to listen to that.
Ja me peame õppima kuulama seda.
Hear from God.
Kuula Jumala käest.
So that we could have his very best in life.
Nii et me saaks olla tema parim meie eludes.
And if you have ever said that before,
ja kui sina varem kunagi oled sellist asja öelnud,
then you, that's just proof that you can hear from God.
Siis see on tõestuse, et sa saad kuulda Jumala käest.
You can hear from
sa
God.
Saad kuulda Jumala käest.
The question is, are we going to listen?
Aga küsimus on selles, kas me kuulame?
Are we going to obey?
Kas me kuuletume?
Or are we just going to do it our way?
Või me lihtsalt teeme oma viisi?
And so, bless you. If we learn to follow the leading of the Holy Spirit,
nii, kui me õppime järgnema Jumala püha vaimule,
it's going to be probably by trial and error in most cases.
Siis tõenäoliselt see saab olema selline...
Trial and error. We do it and then we make mistakes and we learn from those mistakes.
See saab olema nii, et kus kohas me siis õpime vigadest tihti.
And so being led by the Spirit.
Nii et olla siis juhitud Jumala vaimu poolt.
It's not about seeing visions.
Ei ole lihtsalt see, et sa näed mingit nägemusi.
It's not about hearing voices.
Et asja ei ole häälte kuulmises.
Being led by the Holy Spirit is that little small voice on the inside.
Olles juhitud püha vaimu poolt on see, et sa kuuled seda vaikset tasast häält enda sees.
Gentle voice that just says go this way.
Seda õrna häält, mis ütleb sulle, et vali see viis, mine seda teed mööda.
You know, I like in the book of 1 Kings, we won't take time to turn there.
Mulle meeldib esimene kuningate raamat, et hetkel me ei keera sinna.
But 1 Kings chapter 19.
Meil pole aega selle jaoks, aga esimene kuningate raamat 19. peatükk.
Yep. It talks about the man of God going out to hear from God.
Seal räägib sellest, kus Jumala mees läheb välja selleks, et kuulda Jumala käest.
And there is a great big wind and it tore up the mountain.
Ja seal oli selline väga suur tuul, mis rebis selle mäe niimoodi seal.
And he's waiting for God, but God wasn't in the wind.
Aga siis ta ootab seal Jumalat, aga Jumalat ei olnud selles tuules.
And then there was an earthquake that shook everything and he went to hear from God and there was nothing in the earth.
Seal oli selline suur maa värisemine, mis raputas kõik ja siis ta läks sinna, et kuulda seal Jumalat, aga ei olnud midagi.
And then there was a great fire that destroyed everything.
Ja siis seal oli selline suur tuli, mis hävitas kõik.
And he wanted to hear from God, but God was not in the fire.
Ma tahtsin kuulda Jumalat, aga Jumalat ei olnud seal tules.
And then he said, and then there was just that quiet, still voice.
Aga siis ta ütles, et oli selline vaikne, tasane hääl.
And that's where God spoke.
Ja see on see paik, kus kohas Jumal rääkis.
So don't look for the leading of God to be this extravagant something.
Nii et ära otsi, et Jumala see juhtimine on midagi sellist väga suurt ekstravagantset.
Well, God, if you want me to come to church next Sunday.
Jumal, kui sina tahad, et ma järgmine pühapäev tuleksin kogudusse.
I want to see 3 red BMWs before I go home.
Ma tahan näha 3 punast BMW-d enne, kui ma täna koju lähen.
And then I will know that I'm supposed to come back next week.
Siis ma tean, et ma pean järgmine nädal tulema tagasi.
If I don't see 3 red ones.
Kui ma ei näe 3 punast.
And if I see 3 black ones first.
Ja ma näen kõigepealt 3 musta hoopis.
I'm not going to come back.
Siis ma ei tule tagasi.
That's not being led by God.
See ei ole Jumala vaimu poolt juhitud olemine.
That's being led by circumstances.
Vaid see on olla siis juhitud olukordade poolt.
That's being led by chance, like gambling.
See on võimaluste poolt olla juhitud, nii nagu on hasartmängude.
And how many of you know those that gamble are not the most successful people in the
world? Kui paljud teist teavad aga seda, et need, kes on hasartmängurid, nad ei ole kõige edukamad siin elus.
And so it's not about gambling in life. It's about knowing exactly what to do.
Nii et asja ei ole selles, et sa elad seda elu nagu hasartmängu, vaid asja on selles, et sa tead, mida teha.
And it's that quiet, still voice on the inside. He will lead you and he will guide you.
Et see on selline vaikne, tasane hääl sinu sees, et tema siis juhib ja juhatab sind.
He is your God.
Tema on sinu Jumal.
He is your helper.
Tema on su aitaja.
And he's your friend.
Ja ta on su sõber.
And you can trust him with your life.
Ja sina saad usaldada teda oma eluga.
I've trusted him with my life.
Mina olen usaldanud teda oma eluga.
And I am happy and blessed.
Ja ma olen õnnelik ja õnnistatud.
When you trust God with your life, you will be happy and you will be blessed.
Kui sina usaldad Jumalat oma eluga, siis sa saad olema õnnelik ja õnnistatud.
And so the simple leading of God is just knowing in your heart.
Et see lihtne Jumala juhtimine on see, et sa tead oma südames.
And this is why we need to have a foundation in the word.
Ja sellepärast meil peab olema see vundament Jumala sõnast.
Because the Holy Spirit will always speak to us in line with God's word.
Kuna Jumala püha vaim alati kõnetab meid kooskõlas Jumala sõnaga.
That was my introduction, Lord. Help me.
Isant, see oli mu sissejuhatus. Aita mind.
All right, I want us to see how close the Holy Spirit was to the early church.
Ma tahan seda, et me näeksime, kui lähedal oli püha vaim algkogudusele.
And I want us to see how much they relied on him and how much they depended upon him every day.
Ma tahan, et me näeksime seda, kui palju nad toetusid temale ja nad sõltusid temast igapäevaselt.
And this is my thing as we read through the Bible.
Ja asja on selles, et kui me loeme läbi Biibli.
If they did it in the beginning.
Et kui nemad tegid seda alguses.
We should do it today.
Siis meie peaksime tegema seda täna.
If this is how the early church began,
kui see on viis, kuidas algkogudus sai alguse,
then this is how the church is going to end.
Siis see on ka viis, kuidas see kogudus saab lõpetama.
And I believe we are living near the end.
Ja ma usun seda, et me elame lõpule lähemal.
If you look at biblical prophecy,
kui sina vaatad biiblike profeteeringuid,
if you look at and see what the Bible says will happen before the Lord comes back,
kui sa vaatad neid asju, mida Jumala sõna ütleb, et saavad juhtuma enne seda, kui isand tuleb tagasi.
Almost all of it has happened.
Peaaegu kõik need asjad on juba juhtunud.
We're close.
Me oleme väga lähedal.
Now I don't know if he's going to come back before I die.
Ma ei tea seda, kas ta tuleb tagasi enne kui mina ära suren siin.
But my guess would be this just by, you know, trying to say it's probably before your children die.
Aga ma arvan seda, et minu arvamus oleks selline, et tõenäoliselt parem kui sinu lapsed ära surevad.
This next generation, I believe, will see the coming of the Lord.
Ja ma arvan seda, et see tulevane põlgkond, et ta näeb isanda tulemist.
Now, that means we have a job to do.
See tähendab seda, et meil on töö teha.
We have an example to set for
meil
them.
Meil on olemas eesmärk, mida jätta neile.
Amen.
And mida näidata neile.
Even if
meil on olemas eeskuju, mida näidata neile.
And even if he comes back this week,
ja isegi kui ta tuleb tagasi sellel nädalal,
we have a job to do.
Meil on töö teha.
Amen?
Amen.
And so let's do our part.
Nii et teeme enda osa.
Let's hook up to the Holy Spirit and say, I need you today.
Ühendume püha vaimuga, ütleme, et saame ühenduse temaga, ütleme, et ma vajan sind täna.
Because God is faithful.
Kuna Jumal on ustav.
And if he helped them,
ja kui tema aitas neid,
and he used them,
ja ta kasutas neid,
he's going to help us and he's going to use us.
Siis tema aitab meid ja ta kasutab meid.
And so I want you to see how God uses the early church.
Nii et ma tahan, et sa näeksid seda, kuidas Jumal aitas seda algkogudust.
And so go with me to Acts chapter 2.
Nii et mine nüüd apostlite teod teine peatükk.
And what I'm going to do is I just took some highlights throughout the book of Acts.
Ja mida ma tegin on see, et ma võtsin sellised mõned kohad apostlite tegudest.
And I want us to see how awesome the Holy Spirit is.
Ja ma tahan seda, et me näeksime, kui imeline on püha vaim.
Now what we're about to read, this is after the Holy Spirit has been sent by Jesus.
Ja mida me siin nüüd vaatama hakkame on see, et peale seda, kui püha vaim oli saadetud Jeesuse poolt.
He's already come and he's filled the believers.
Ta on juba tulnud ja ta on täitnud usklikud.
And after this Peter goes out to the city and he begins to preach.
Ja peale seda Peetrus läheb linna ja ta hakkab seal jutlustama.
And in Acts chapter 2 I want to read verses 38 and verse 39.
Apostlite teod 2:38 ja 39.
It says, and Peter replied, repent and be baptized every one of you in the name of Jesus Christ for the forgiveness of sin and receive the gift of the Holy Spirit.
Aga Peetrus ütles neile, parandage meelt, iga üks teist lasku ennast ristida Jeesuse Kristuse nimesse oma patud andeks saamiseks ning siis te saate püha vaimu anni.
And the promise is for you and for your children and all who are far off, for all whom the Lord will call.
See teotus on antud teile ja teie lastele ning kõikidele, kes on eemal, keda iganes Jumal meie issand enese juurde kutsub.
Do you know you're included in that verse?
Aga kas sa tead, et sind on ka siis kaasatud sinna salmi?
You're one of those that's far off.
Sina oled üks nendest, kes on seal eemal.
Now I'm not talking about you mentally, I'm just talking about chronologically.
Ma ei räägi kuidagi niimoodi mõtteliselt, kuidagi mõistuseliselt, vaid ajaliselt.
That we are included here.
Et meid on, me oleme ka siin olemas siin salmis.
This gift.
Et see kingitus.
This promise.
See teotus.
Is for us.
See on meie jaoks.
And we see here that when Peter is preaching this, he just said, this is the natural thing that should happen. This is the natural progression.
Me näeme seda, et kui Peetus siin rääks, et see on selline loomulik asi, mis peab toimuma, see on selline loomulik edasiminek.
And he talks about the three baptisms that we've talked about in this series.
Ja ta räägib kolmest ristimisest, millest me varem rääksime siin seerias.
He talks about the blood, he talks about the water, he talks about the oil.
Ta räägib verest, veest ja õlist.
He talked about giving your lives to Jesus.
Ta rääkis sellest, et sa peaksid oma elu andma Jeesusele.
Being baptized in water.
Saama ristitud vees.
And receive the Holy Spirit.
Ja vastu võtma püha vaimu.
This is Old Testament, New Testament, today.
See on Vana Testament, Uus Testament täna.
Amen.
Amen.
This is what we need.
See on see, mida meie vajame.
This is available to us if we will believe and if we will act.
See on saadal meie jaoks, kui me usume ja kui me siis tegutseme.
And having the Holy Spirit as part of our daily walk is vital.
Omada püha vaimu, see on vajalik meie jaoks, meie igapäevases elus.
And we see how this was just a natural progression.
Ja me näeme seda, kus oli selline loomulik edasiminek.
And the story goes a couple verses later.
Ja see lugu läheb edasi mõned salmid hiljem.
That day 3,000 people got saved.
Sellel päeval 3,000 inimest sai päästetud.
Woo! Woo! What a start for the church.
Milline algus koguduse jaoks.
Amen.
Amen.
I mean, that would be good for us.
See oleks hea meie jaoks.
But 3,000 people in one day.
Aga 3,000 inimest ühe päevaga.
That was 3%, over 3% of what historians say lived in Jerusalem in that time.
See oli natukene rohkem kui 3% inimestest, nii nagu ajaloolased räägivad, sellel ajal elas seal linnas.
They say there was between 80 and 100,000 people that lived in Jerusalem.
Seal öeldakse, et seal elas umbes 80 kuni 100 000 inimest Jerusalemas.
3,000 people of them got saved.
Ja 3,000 neist said päästetud.
That would be like 15,000 people getting saved in our city in one day.
See on nii nagu 15 000 saaksid päästetud ühel päeval siin meie linnas.
How many of you know that would make some excitement?
Kui paljud teist teavad, et see tekitaks põnevust.
That would bring some fire into the church.
See tooks sellist tuld kogudusse.
And the church started with this excitement and with this fire and with this momentum.
Ja kogudus algas selle põnevusega, selle tulega, selle hooga.
And it made an impact in that city.
Ja see avaldas mõju selles linnas.
And so they were born again, they were all filled with the Spirit.
Nii et nad olid uuesti sündinud, nad kõik olid täidetud Jumala vaimuga.
And the church was established and the church began to grow.
Ja see kogudus oli rajatud ja see kogudus hakkas kasvama.
That wasn't the end, that was just the beginning.
See ei olnud asja lõpp, vaid see oli lihtsalt algus.
And so then there was time that went by and then they were going around preaching the gospel.
Ja siis oli aeg, mis läksime edasi ja nemad läksid ka liikusid edasi ja kuulutasid evangeeliumit.
And then the time came that the church was going to be threatened.
Ja siis tuli selline aeg, kus kohas hakati kogudust ähvardama.
And they were told not to teach about Jesus anymore.
Ja neile öeldi, et nad enam ei kuulutaks Jeesusest.
And if you teach about Jesus, we're going to throw you in prison, we're going to punish you.
Kui te õpetate Jeesus, siis me heidame teid vangi ja me karistame teid.
And so the church got together.
Ja siis kogudus tuli kokku.
And they began to pray.
Ja nad hakkasid palvetama.
And in Acts chapter 4 and verse 29.
Ja apostlite teod 4. peatükk salm 29.
Says, now Lord, consider their threats and enable your servants to speak with great boldness.
Siin ütleb ja nüüd issand vaata nende ähvarduste peale lase oma sulastel täie julgusega kõnelda sinu sõna.
And so this was their prayer, God, we want to continue to be bold for you.
Nii et see oli see palve, nende palve Jumala poole, Jumala, me tahame olla jätkuvalt julged sinu jaoks.
But we can't do it in our own strength, we need help.
Aga me ei saa teha seda kuidagi enda jõust, me vajame abi.
We need you.
Me vajame sind.
We need you.
Me vajame sind.
Help us, God.
Aita meid, Jumal.
Help us, God.
Aita meid, Jumal.
How did God answer the prayer?
Kuidas Jumal vastas sellele palvele?
Down here in verse 31 it says, and after they prayed, the place where they were meeting was shaken, and they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke the word of God boldly.
Järgmine salm 30 siis sirutades oma käe haigete parandamiseks ning tunnust.
No, verse 31. Oh, did I? 31. 31, please. Sorry, I wrote down the wrong verse there for you.
Apostlite teod 4. peatükk salm 31.
Says, and after they prayed, the place where their meeting was shaken, they were all filled with the Holy Spirit and spoke the word of God boldly.
Ja nende palve järel kõik, kus paik, kus nad olid koos ja nad kõik täideti püha vaimuga ja nad kõnelesid Jumala sõna julgesti.
How did God answer their prayer?
Kuidas Jumal vastas nende palvele?
He filled them with the Holy Spirit.
Ta täitis neid püha vaimuga.
And when they were filled with the Holy Spirit, they went out and they spoke boldly.
Ja kui nad olid täidetud püha vaimuks, nad läksid välja ja nad rääksid julgelt.
Amen. That's awesome.
See on imeline.
That's the answer to prayer.
See on palve vastusele.
The Holy Spirit gave them the boldness to talk.
See on see vastus palvele, see püha vaim andis neile julguse rääkida.
Just like Jesus promised.
Täpselt nii nagu Jeesus tõotas.
That he's going to come upon you and he will be in you.
Et ta tuleb teie peale ja ta saab olema teie sees.
And he will give you power to go out and be witnesses.
Ja ta annab teile selle väe, et minna välja ja olla tunnistajaks.
You'll go out into the world to preach the gospel.
Et te lähete välja ja kuulutate evangeeliumit.
And so we need the Holy Spirit.
Et me vajame püha vaimu.
God gave them this boldness.
Jumal andis neile selle julguse.
This is the same group that had already been filled in Acts chapter 2.
See on see sama grupp, kes juba seal apostlite teod teine peatükk oli saanud täidetud.
And we see that they were filled again or refilled.
Me näeme seda, et nad said jälle täidetud. Nad said uuesti täidetud.
So this shows us that it's an ongoing thing. This should be a daily thing for us.
Nii et see näitab, et see on selline jätkuv asi, et see peaks olema igapäevane asi meie jaoks.
It's not a one-time thing. Well, yeah, I was filled with the Holy Spirit back in 1982.
Et see ei ole selline ühekordne asi, et jah, et ma sain täidetud püha vaimuga aastal 1992.
No, it should be a daily thing.
Ei, see peaks olema igapäevane asi.
He's going to help us. He's going to strengthen us.
Et tema aitab meid, ta tugevdab meid.
And he's going to use us.
Ja ta kasutab meid.
And so the Spirit brings the answer.
Niin että vaim toob vastused.
And as he did it for them,
ja niin nagu ta tegi nende jaoks,
do it for you.
Ta teeb ka sinu jaoks.
And then we go on and some time passes and then there's a man named Saul.
Ja siis me läheme edasi ja aega läheb sinna nüüd mööda ja siis seal on mees Saul.
And Saul has been sent out by the religious leaders to stop the church.
Ja Saul oli siis välja läkitatud religioossete juhtide poolt selle jaoks, et peatada kogudust.
And the way he's doing this,
ja see viis, kuidas tema teeb seda,
he's killing Christians.
On see, et ta tapab kristlasi.
He's imprisoning Christians.
Ta paneb kristlasi vangi.
He's dividing families.
Ta siis eraldab perekondi.
He's chasing people out of towns.
Ta ajab inimesi linnadest välja.
And he's doing everything he can to stop the church.
Ja ta teeb kõike, mida ta suudab selle jaoks, et peatada kogudust.
One day he's walking on the road going to another city to do the same job again.
Ühel päeval ta kõnnib tee peal minnes järgmisesse linna, et teha seda sama asja jälle.
He's going to go kill Christians.
Ta plaan oli see, et minna ja tappa kristlasi.
And listen, he was not doing this because he was a mean, ruthless man.
Ja kuule nüüd, et ta ei teinud seda sellepärast, et ta oli selline kuidagi julm ja selline külma südamega kuidagi selline väga jube mees, karm mees.
He was doing this because he thought he was being God's tool.
Vaid ta tegi seda selle jaoks, et ta arvas, et ta on Jumala tööriist.
He thought this was going against the plan of God, this little church that had started.
Ta mõtles, et see asi, see läheb Jumala plaani vastu, see väike koguduse värk, mida seal alustatakse.
And we need to stop it.
Ja meie peame peatama selle.
And so he thought that he was doing this for God.
Ja ta mõtles, et ta teeb seda Jumala jaoks.
And as he's going to Damascus, the spirit of Jesus appears to him.
Ja kui tema läheb sinna Damaskusesse, siis Jeesus vaim ilmus talle.
So Saul, what are you doing to me?
Ja ta ütles, et Saul, mida sa teed minu jaoks?
And he was like, whoa.
Ja ta ütles niimoodi, wow.
I thought I was doing what you wanted
ma
me
mõtles,
to do.
Ma teen seda, mida sa tahtsid, et ma teeksin.
And so the story goes that he was told to go to a man's house.
Niis, et see lugu läheb seal edasi, kus öeldakse, et ta siis tal öeldi, et ta läheks ühe mehe majja.
And wait there.
Ja et oota seal.
Then the Holy Spirit speaks to another man's name's Ananias.
Siis püha vaim kõnetas ühte teist meest, kelle nimi oli Hananias.
I love this story.
Ja ma väga armastan seda lugu.
Because who was Ananias?
Sellepärast, kes oli Hananias?
Nobody.
Mitte keegi.
Nobody.
Ta ei olnud mitte keegi.
He wasn't an apostle.
Ta ei olnud apostel.
He didn't really know Jesus when he was living on the earth.
Ta tegelikult ei õigesti tunnud Jeesus, kui ta elas siin maa peal.
He wasn't some great preacher that everybody knew.
Ta polnud keegi suur vägev jutustaja, keda kõik teadsid.
He was just a guy.
Ta oli lihtsalt üks mees.
That knew God.
Kes teadis, tundis Jumalat.
Who's like, Lord, show me what to do today.
Ja kes oli nii, ütles, et Jumal, näita mulle, mida täna teha.
I love you.
Et ma armastan sind.
I thank you, Jesus, you're my Lord.
Jeesus, ma tänan sind sellest, et sina oled minu isand.
Show me what to do.
Näita mulle, mida täna teha.
God said, go pray for that guy, Saul.
Jumal ütles, et mina palveta selle mehe ees, selle Sauli eest.
Really, God, are you sure you got the right guy?
Kas tõesti, Jumal, kas sa oled kindel, et sa ikka valised õige mehe?
God said, yeah.
Ja ta ütles, et jah.
Now look here in where am I at? Chapter 9, verse 17.
Ja nüüd ma olen siis 9. peatükk, psalm 17.
And then Ananias went to the house and entered in and placing his hands on Saul, he said, brother, Saul, the Lord Jesus who appeared to you on the road as you were coming here has sent me to you that you might see again and be filled with the Holy Spirit.
Siis Ananias läks ja astus sisse sinna kotta ja pannud oma käed Saulise peale, ütles Saul vend, issand on mu läkitanud, Jeesus kes end sulle näitas teel, mida mööda sa tulid, et sa jälle näeksid ja saaksid täis püha vaimu.
You know what the biggest thing there is?
Kas teate, mis on see kõige suurem asi seal?
I believe it's not just that Ananias knew what happened to Saul.
Et ma mõtlen, et see ei ole lihtsalt see asi, et see Hananias teadis, mis juhtus Saulile.
It's not just about him knowing where to come find him.
Mitte lihtsalt see, et ta teadis, kuhu tulla, et teda leida.
It says as he prayed for him.
Vaid see, et ta palvetas tema ees.
He prayed that he'd be filled with the Holy Spirit.
Palvetas, et ta saaks täidetud püha vaimuga.
This religious man who had so much teaching.
See religioosne mees, kelle oli nii palju õpetust.
He was the teacher of teachers.
Et ta oli õpetajate õpetaja.
He knew the word of God.
Ta teadis Jumala sõna.
And now he's filled with the Holy Spirit.
Ja nüüd on täidetud püha vaimuga.
And it changes everything that he knows.
Ja see muudab kõik selle, mida ta teab.
Changes everything that he's ever believed.
See muudab kõik selle, mida ta on kunagi uskunud.
And now he sees clearly his path for his life.
Nüüd ta näeb selgelt oma teed, oma elu jaoks.
He's filled with the Holy Spirit.
Ta on täidetud püha vaimuga.
And he went out and he told everybody about Jesus.
Ja ta läks välja ja ta rääkis kõikidele Jeesusest.
And so he was this man that desired to be led by the Holy Spirit.
Nii et ta oli see mees, kes igatses olla juhitud Jumala vaimu poolt.
He wanted to be led by the Holy Spirit daily.
Ta tahtis olla juhitud Jumala vaimu poolt igapäevaselt.
He understood that the Spirit of God has opened up the whole Bible to him.
Ta mõistis seda, et see Jumala püha vaim, et see on avanud kogu piibli tema jaoks.
The Holy Scriptures are now available.
Et ne, see püha sõna on saadaval tema jaoks.
And he's not reading it by word, he's reading it by revelation.
Ja ta ei loe seda kuidagi sõna kaupa, vaid ta loeb seda läbi ilmutuse.
And it changed everything that we believe.
Ja see muutis kõik selle, mida meie praegu usume.
And so here this Saul gets saved.
Ja siin see Saul siis saab päästetud.
Then there, as the time goes on in chapter 11.
Aga siis kui aeg läheb edasi peatükis 11.
Here's the great apostle Peter.
Ja siin on see vägev apostel Peetrus.
He's doing what he knows best to try to win people to Jesus and tell people what Jesus has done.
Ta tegi parimat, mida ta teadis teha, et minna ja rääkida, kuulutada Jeesusest ja et inimesed saaksid päästetud.
And then he has this vision about he's supposed to go eat some unkosher food.
Ta on olemas selline visioon, et ta peab minema sööma sellist kosheri välissööki.
And for a Jewish person to go and eat some pig would have been like blasphemy.
Ja see, et selline juut läheb ja sööb, siis sealt sealiha oleks olnud selline väga jube asi.
And so this was something that God showed him. It's, you know, it's okay. You're going to go to the Gentiles. You're going to eat this food. It's okay.
Et see oli midagi sellist, kus Jumal näitas tal, et jah, mine sinna paganate juurde ja söö koos nendega, et see kõik on täiesti okei.
And so here we see in Acts chapter 11, and we're going to read from verse 12 here.
Ja siin me näeme siis apostlite teod 11, salmis 2.
And the Spirit told me not to hesitate to go with them. He knew these men were coming.
Aga see vaim ütles mulle, et ma läheksin, et ma ei kõhkleks koos nendega.
He knew these men were coming.
Ta teadis seda, et need mehed on tulemas.
And the Spirit told me not to hesitate to go.
Ja vaim ütles mulle, et ma ei kahtleks minekus.
Where did he hear the voice of the Spirit?
Kus kohas ta kuulis vaimu häält?
It wasn't with these ears.
See ei olnud nende kõrvadega.
It was on the inside.
See oli tema sees.
He just knew when these guys come, I'm supposed to go with them.
Ta lihtsalt teadis seda, et kui need mehed tulevad, ma pean minema koos nendega.
That knowing on the inside.
See teadmine oma sees.
Let's jump down to verse 15.
Ja hüppame edasi salmi 15.
He went with these guys. He went and preached to these people.
Ta läks koos nende meestega, ta läks ja kuulutas nendele inimestele.
And as I began to speak, the Holy Spirit came on them just as he had come on us in the beginning.
Kui ma siis hakkasin rääkima, langes püha vaim nende peale, nii nagu meiegi peale alguses.
And so this was a surprise.
Nii et see oli üllatus.
Because now that he was seeing that the Holy Spirit was not just for the Jews.
Sellepärast, et nüüd ta nägi seda, et see püha vaim ei olnud ainult juutide jaoks.
It's not just for the apostles of God.
Mitte lihtsalt Jumala apostlite jaoks.
You know, I've heard preachers say, well, it was just for the apostles of God to get the church started. That's why the Holy Spirit came.
Ma olen kuulnud seda, kus mõned jutustajad on öelnud, et see püha vaim oli ainult apostlite jaoks, selle jaoks, et kogudus saaks alguse.
Well, no, he's still here.
Ei, et ta on ikkagi siin.
He's still doing a work in us.
Ta ikkagi teeb tööd meie sees.
It's not just for the Jews, it's not just for the apostles, it's for everybody who would believe.
Et ta ei ole lihtsalt juutide jaoks, lihtsalt apostlite jaoks, vaid kõigi jaoks, kes usuvad.
Do you believe?
Kas sina usud?
Do you believe you can have this power in your life?
Kas sina usud, et sul võib olla tema vägi sinu elus?
Are you looking for this power in your life?
Kas sina ootad seda väge oma elus?
Are you expecting him to show up in your life?
Kas sa ootad seda, et ta ilmub välja su elus?
Peter was.
Peetrus, jah, oli.
And then Peter went out and he saw that the Holy Spirit filled all of them.
Peetrus läks välja ja ta nägi seda, et püha vaim täitis nemad kõike.
And this was awesome.
Ja see oli väga imeline.
And this precious gift.
Ja see väga kalli hinnaline kingitus.
This gift of salvation.
See pääste kingitus.
This gift of the Holy Spirit.
See püha vaimu kingitus.
Was given even to those who were not Jews.
Need ainult isegi neile, kes ei olnud juudid.
It was for everybody in the world.
See oli iga ühe jaoks maailmas.
And so we are called to be witnesses.
Need meid on kutsutud olema tunnistajaks.
And we are called to go out and to tell people about Jesus.
Meid on kutsutud, et minna välja ja rääkida inimestele Jeesusest.
And if we will do that,
ja kui meie teeme seda,
the Holy Spirit will help us to do it.
Püha vaim aitab meil seda teha.
There is a way. There's a strategy.
On olemas selline viis ja strateegia.
For every person you know.
Iga inimese jaoks, keda sina tunned.
For you to be able to share God with them.
Nii et sa oled võimeline jagama Jumalat temaga.
We've got to be led by the Holy Spirit.
Me peame olema juhitud Jumala vaimu poolt.
And then Paul here.
Ja Paulus siin.
This guy Saul later changed his name, became Paul.
Et see Saul siis, ta hiljem muutis oma nime ära ja temast sai Paul.
Now,
Paulus.
Let's go to chapter 16.
Ja läheme peatükki 16.
Chapter 16 and verse 6. And now here Paul is wanting to preach the gospel. He's wanting to take the gospel into Asia.
Paulus tahab kuulutada evangeeliumi, tahab viia evangeeliumi Aasiasse.
That was the idea Paul had.
See oli see idee, mis Paulusel oli.
Paul thought, all right, let's go to Asia, let's preach the gospel there. There's lots of people there, they need to hear.
Paulus mõtles, et lähme Aasiasse kuulutama selle evangeeliumi, seal on väga palju inimesi, kes pead kuulma.
But we see as he tried to go to preach in Asia, the Holy Spirit kept turning him back to Europe.
Aga me näeme seda, et kui ta proovis minna siis sinna Aasiasse, et seal kuulutada, siis püha vaime juhatas teda nii, et ta pöördus ümber, tuli tagasi Euroopasse.
Let's look here in Acts 16, I'll start reading with verse 6.
Apostel teod 16, alustan lugemist salmis 6.
It says, Paul and his companions traveled throughout the region of Persia and Galatia, and having been kept from the Spirit from preaching the word of God in the province of Asia.
Ja nemad läksid läbi Früügi ja Galaatia maa, sest püha vaim oli keelanud neil sõna rääkimast Aasias.
And when they came near the border of Mysia, they tried to enter Bithynia, but the Spirit of Jesus would not allow them to go.
Kui nad jõudsid Müüsiani, püüdsid matkata Bithyniasse, aga Jeesuse vaim ei lubanud.
What do you mean God wouldn't allow them to go?
Mis mõttes Jumal ei lubanud neil minna?
God gives us a free will. We can do whatever we want.
Jumal annab meile vaba tahte, me võime teha kõike seda, mida me tahame.
It was just that knowing on the inside that, oh, I want to go there, but it just doesn't feel right.
See oli selline teadmine sees, et ma tahan sinna minna, aga see lihtsalt ei tundu õigena.
I want to go preach the gospel to those people, but I just, it's not the right thing to do. It's not the right time, so let's go here.
Ma tahan minna kuulutada neile evangeeliumit, aga see ei tundu praegu õige, see ei tundu õige aeg olevalt, nii et lähme parem siia üldse teise kohta.
God has a strategy.
Jumal on olemas strateegia.
Amen. And the Amen. Spirit of God knows the strategy
ja
of God.
Ja Jumala vaim teab strateegiat.
And so here they're ready to go.
Ja siin nad on valmis minema.
And they just kept feeling like, no, it's not yet, not yet, not yet.
Ja neil oli siis jätkuvalt selline tunne, et ei, mitte veel, mitte veel.
Verse 8, and they passed by the Mysidia and went down to Troas.
Nii tulid nad Müüsiast möödudes alla Troasesse.
And during the night, Paul had a vision of a man of Macedonia standing and begging him, saying, come over here to Macedonia and help us.
Ja Paulus nägi öösel nägemuse, üks Makedoonia mees seisis ja palus teda, tule meie juurde Makedooniasse, aita meid.
And after Paul had seen the vision,
ja kui ta oli seda nägemust näinud,
we got ready at once to leave for Macedonia, concluding that God had called us to go preach to them.
Püüdsime kohe minna Makedooniasse olles veendunud, et issand on meid kutsunud neile evangeeliumi kuulutama.
Paul had a dream.
Paulusel oli unenägu.
Of a guy that was standing there saying, come tell us.
Mehest, kes ütles, et seisid, ütles, et tule meie juurde, palun.
So they thought, let's just go there then, because we don't really feel led to go the other
place. Ja siis ta mõtles, et lähme hoopis parem sinna, et kuna ma ei tunne praegu juhtimist, et minna sinna Aasiasse.
They talked about it, they prayed about it.
Nad rääksid sellest, nad palatsid sellest.
And just felt, okay, well that's the thing to do, let's go.
Ja see tundus olevat õige asi, mida teha, et lähme.
And so we see that the Holy Spirit led them.
Me näeme seda, et püha vaim juhtis neid.
And they did what seemed right to them and to the Holy Spirit.
Nad tegid neid asju, mis näis õige olevas nende jaoks ja püha vaimu jaoks.
And they were spirit led.
Ja nad olid vaimu poolt
juhitud. Not opportunity led.
Mitte võimaluste poolt juhitud.
The opportunity said go to Asia because there's so many more people there.
Võimalus ütles, et minge Aasiasse, kuna seal on veel nii palju inimesi.
But the Spirit led them to Macedonia and to begin to take the gospel to Europe.
Aga see vaime juhtis neid Makedooniasse nii, et nad läksid ja viisid evangeeliumi Euroopasse.
And so God had a plan.
Nii et Jumalal oli plaan.
On how to get the gospel to the world.
Kuidas saada see evangeelium maailmasse.
It went to Europe and then it's gone to America.
See läks Euroopasse ja siis läks edasi Ameerikasse.
And now it's gone around the world.
Ja nüüd on see läinud üle kogu maailma.
But there was a plan.
Aga seal oli olemas plaan.
There was a strategy of God.
Seal oli olemas Jumala strateegia.
Thank God we're included.
Tänu Jumala on selle eest, et me oleme sinna kaasatud.
Amen.
Amen.
Now, to go to Asia.
Nüüd, et minna Aasiasse.
If God calls you to go, go.
Kui Jumal kutsub sind sinna minema, siis mine.
It's time for the world to know.
Maailmal on aeg teada.
It's time for the world to see truth.
Maailmal on aeg näha tõde.
Follow the Spirit of God.
Järgne Jumala vaimule.
Truth is though, most of you aren't going to go to Asia.
Tõde on see, et enamus teist ei lähe Aasiasse.
Most of you are just going to go to Lasnamäe.
Enamus teist läheb Lasnamäele.
Kesklinna. Mustamäele, Viimsisse. That's where we're going to go.
Need on need kohad, kus kohta me läheme.
That's where God has called us.
See on see, kui Jumal on kutsunud meid.
Amen.
Amen.
So go and be who God wants you to go and be.
Nii et mina ei ole see, keda Jumal tahab, et sa oleksid.
And so God still has a plan on how to spread the world spread the gospel throughout the world today.
Nii et Jumal on olemas plaan siis kuidas ka siis tänapäeval seda evangeeliumi levitada.
We have to be open and led by the Holy Spirit.
Me peame olema avatud ja juhitud Jumala vaimu poolt.
To know where and to know how.
Teada seda, et millal ja kuhu, kuidas.
To know where and to know how.
Teada kuhu ja kuidas.
And if we will spend time with him, he'll tell us.
Ja kui me veedame aega temaga, siis ta ütleb meile.
Hallelujah. And then later on,
ja ilm siis,
when Paul's life is nearing the end,
kui Pauluse elu on hakkama jõudma lõppu poole,
he knew that he was going to have to go back to Jerusalem.
Ta teadis seda, et ta peab minema tagasi Jerusalemma.
And he was going to, you know, and there they were probably going to end up sending him away to Rome because that's what God told him from the very beginning.
Ja seal on tõenäos, et saadab teda siia Rooma, kuna Jumal oli seda tal alguses öelnud.
But here in Acts chapter 20, let's go a couple more chapters.
Aga siin Apostlite teod 20 ja lähme siis mõned peatükid edasi.
Acts chapter 20, I want to start reading here with verse 22.
Apostlite teod 20, ta on alustatud salmis 22.
And said, and now compelled by the Spirit.
Ja nüüd vaata, ma lähen vaimus seotuna.
He was compelled by the Spirit.
Et ta oli vaimus seotud, et ta oli õhutatud vaimu poolt.
He was being led by God in everything he did and everywhere he went.
Ta oli juhitud Jumala vaimu poolt kõiges, mida ta tegi ja kuhu ta läks.
You see how real the Spirit of God was to the early church?
Kas sa näed seda, kui reaalne oli Jumala vaime algkogudusele?
Involved in everything that they did.
Ta oli kaasatud kõike sellesse, mida nemad tegid.
He said, now I'm compelled by the Spirit, I'm going to Jerusalem, not knowing what's going to happen to me there.
Ja ta ütles, et ma lähen vaimus seotune Jerusalema teadmata, mis see mulle seal võib, mis mul seal võib juhtuda.
So he's saying, I don't know everything.
Ja ta ütles, et ma ei tea kõike.
But listen to this next verse.
Aga kuule seda järgmist salmi.
He said, but I do know this.
Kui ta ütles, et ma tean seda.
That I only know that in every city the Holy Spirit warns me that prison and hardship are facing me.
Peale selle, mida püha vaim mul igas linnas tunnistab, et mind ootavad ahelad ja viletsused.
Yeah, I don't know step by step what's going to happen, but it's probably not going to be great.
Ma ei tea, mis kõik sammult toimuma saab, aga ma tean, et see ei saa olema midagi väga ilusat.
For me.
Minu jaoks.
I'm going to preach the gospel, people will get saved.
Mina kuulutan evangeeliumit, inimesed saavad päästetud.
I'm going to end up in prison and I'm going to end up having hard times.
Mina satun vanglasse ja mul saad olema väga rasked ajad.
The Spirit compelled me.
Ja see Jumala vaim siis õhutas mind minema.
And I know the Spirit has told me that in every city.
Ja ma tean seda, et Jumala vaim on mulle öelnud seda, et igas linnas.
Everywhere I go now.
Igale poole, kuhu ma nüüd lähen.
This is what's going to happen.
On see, mis saab juhtuma.
This is my life.
See on minu elu.
Was he sad?
Kas ta oli kurb?
Was he mad at God?
Kas ta oli vihane Jumala peale?
Is he like, God, why me?
Kas ta oli nii, et Jumal, mille pärast mina?
I'm doing what you want me to do and I go to prison.
Ma teen seda, mida sa tahad, et ma teeksin, ma lähen vangi.
Look at verse 24. I love Paul's heart.
Vaata salmi 24, et ma väga armastan Pauluse südant.
This is why he was mightily used by God in the world.
Ja see on see, mille pärast oli vääriselt kasutatud siin maailmas Jumala poolt.
However, I consider my life worth nothing to me if only I may finish the race and complete the task the Lord Jesus Christ has given me, the task of testifying the gospel of God's grace.
Kuid ma ei pea oma elu mingil kombel endale kalliks, vaid püüan lõpule viia oma elu töö ja ülesande, mille ma olen saanud Issanda Jeesuse käest tunnistada Jumala armu evangeeliumi.
Paul knew it was the plan of God.
Paulus teadis, et see on Jumala plaan.
He knew God was going to be with him.
Ta teadis seda, et Jumal saab olema koos temaga.
So he boldly went.
Nii et ta julgelt läks.
Because he said, for me, this is my life.
Kuna ta ütles, et minu jaoks see on mu elu.
What gives me excitement?
Mis annab mulle põnemuse?
What gives me joy?
Mis annab mulle rõõmu?
What gives me satisfaction?
Mis annab mulle rahulduse?
Is that I will go and I will do what the Lord wants me to do.
Et ma lähen seda ja ma teen seda, mida Isand tahab, et ma teeksin.
And I'll just tell everybody about Jesus.
Ma lihtsalt lähen ja räägin kõikidele Jeesusest.
And if they let me go into the city, I'll go tell the city.
Kui nad lasevad mul minna linna, siis ma lähen sinna linna.
If they put me in prison, I'll tell the whole prison.
Kui nad panad mind vanglasse, ma räägin kogu kõikidele vangidele
seal. If they put me in the court, I'll tell all the judges.
Kui nad saadab mind kohtusse, siis ma räägin seal kõikidele kohtunikele.
I'm just going to talk about Jesus, talk about Jesus, talk about Jesus, talk about Jesus.
Ma lihtsalt räägin Jeesusest, ma räägin Jeesusest, ma räägin Jeesusest.
He's my savior, my lord.
Tema on minu päästaja, minu isand.
What gave him the boldness?
Mis andis talle selle julguse?
The Spirit of God.
Jumala vaime.
The Spirit is compelling me to go.
Jumala vaim õhutab mind minema.
The Spirit is going to be with me.
Jumala vaim on koos
minuga. And I know it's going to be tough, but he's there with me. He's the one that's called me there.
Ma tean seda, et see saab olema raske, aga tema on kutsunud mind, tema on läkitanud mind sinna.
And if it's the plan of God, you can do it.
Ja kui see on Jumala plaan, siis sa saad seda teha.
Amen.
Amen.
If it's the plan of God, you can make it.
Kui see on Jumala plaan, siis sa saad saada hakkama.
Our job is to make sure, is it the plan of God?
Meie osa on teha kindlaks see, et kas see on Jumala plaan.
Am I doing what God wants me to do?
Kas ma teen seda, mida Jumal tahab, et ma
teeksin? Am I fulfilling the call that is upon my life?
Kas ma täidan seda kutset, mis on minu elu üle?
And the Holy Spirit led Paul to live an amazing life.
Ja püha vaim juhtis Paulust elama väga imelist elu.
He saw some amazing things before he got to go home and be with Jesus.
Ta nägi hämmastavaid asju enne seda, kui ta läks koju Isanda Jeesuse juurde.
But Paul was a man who simply followed the Spirit of God every day of his life.
Aga Paulus oli mees, kes väga lihtsalt siis järgis Jumala vaimu iga päev oma elus, igale poole kuhu ta läks.
Use me.
Jumal, kasuta mind.
Use me.
Kasuta mind.
I think that should be your prayer this morning is God, use me.
Ma mõtlen seda, et see peaks olema sinu palve täna hommikul, et Jumal kasuta mind.
Holy Spirit, lead me and guide me.
Püha vaim juhi ja juhata mind.
Show up in my life.
Ilmu välja minu elus.
As you read through this, you see it's a help, it's a power, it's life.
Kui sa loed seda, sa näed seda, et see on abi, see on vägi, see on elu.
That's why I've said every week, if you'll just read your Bible, you will desire to have the Holy Spirit in your life.
Sellepärast ma ütlen sulle iga nädal, et kui sa loed Biiblit, siis sa igatsed püha vaim oma ellu.
Because wherever you go and whatever he asks you to do, you're going to enjoy it to the full.
Sellepärast igale poole, kui sa lähed, mida sa teed, sa naudid seda täielikult.
So being led by the Holy Spirit is one of the most important things that you and I can learn in life.
Nii et olla juhitud püha vaimu poolt on üks kõige tähtsamad asju, mis meil saab olla siin elus.
And to be confident that we're hearing from him.
Et olla kindel, et me kuuleme tema käest.
We gotta know the word.
Me peame tundma sõna.
Because Jesus said he's going to take the word and he's going to remind you of it.
Kuna Jeesus ütles, et ta võtab sõna ja ta tuletab sulle seda meelde.
And he's going to take from what is in me and he's going to make it known to you.
Ta võtab seda, mis on minu käest ja ta teeb selle teatavaks
sulle.
That's
awesome.
Ja see on väga imeline
asi. I need that.
Mina vajan seda.
I want to know Jesus.
Ma tahan tunda Jeesus.
In a better way.
Paremal viisil.
In a closer way.
Lähedasemal viisil.
And it's through the Spirit of God and that friendship, that relationship.
Ja see on läbi Jumala vaimu, läbi selle suhte, läbi selle sõprus suhte.
He's going to lead you.
Tema juhib sind.
To Jesus.
Tema juhib sind
Jeesus. He's going to lead you.
Ta juhib sind.
To the word.
Jumala sõnasse.
He's going to lead you.
Ta juhib sind.
To people.
Inimeste juurde.
Amen.
Amen.
He's going to lead you in what you say. He's going to lead you in what you do.
Ta juhib sind selles, mida öelda, mida teha, kuhu minna.
And it's going to make you better.
Ja ta teeb sind paremaks.
He's going to give you gifts and abilities to get the job done.
Ta annab sulle annid ja võimed selle jaoks, et see töö saaks tehtud.
He's going to bless this church so that we get the job done.
Ta õnnistab seda kogust, et see töö meie läbi saaks tehtud.
I'm believing God for greater things, church.
Ma usun Jumala käest vägevamaid asju kogudus.
God has got some things. I mean, we're just about ready to step into some things. And if I could tell you everything right now, you'd be excited.
Jumal on olemas mõndasid sellised asju, kuhu me oleme kohe sisse astumas ja kui ma sulle ütleksin, sa oleksid väga põnevil.
I'm not going to say everything right now today.
Ma ei ütle kõike täna.
But I do want to tell you this.
Aga ma tahan sulle öelda seda.
God is moving and there's some things that have been rolling around in my heart.
Et Jumal liigub ja on olemas mõned asjad, mis on niimoodi keerelnud minu südame ümber.
God's been speaking to me by the Holy Spirit things about our church for months.
Jumal on rääkinud mulle meie koguduse kohta niimoodi kuude kaupa.
And I, at first I didn't know why.
Alguses ma ei teanud, mille pärast.
Well, I know why is to reach people, okay.
Ma tean ja mille pärast selleks, et jõuda inimeste.
I just didn't know how.
Ma lihtsalt ei teanud, kuidas.
I was like, how?
Ma olin nii, et Jumal, et kuidas.
How do we do it? And he would speak to me, I was like, but God, how is that going to happen?
Ta rääkis mulle, et ma ütlesin Jumala, et näita Jumal, kuidas seda teha.
I asked God, how is it going to happen?
Ja ma küsin Jumala käest, kuidas seda teha.
And so there are some big things that I believe as a church we need to do.
Ma usun seda, et on olemas mõned suured asjad, mida meie kogudusena peame tegema.
And right now is the time.
Ja praegu on aeg.
We're going to step in this next month or so, we're going to step into some amazing things.
Kus me läheme sisse järgmisesse kuusse või nii ja siis me saame nägema vägevaid asju.
And I believe to do what we're going to do.
Ja ma usun seda, et selleks, et teha seda, mida me hakkame tegema.
It's going to help us to accomplish the plan of God that he has for this church and for this city.
See aitab saavutada seda plaani, mis Jumalal on selle koguduse jaoks ja selle linna jaoks.
And so I felt led by God to make some changes in our church and the way that we do things.
Ma olen tulnud Jumala poolt juhtimist, et muut asju, mida me oma koguduses teeme ja seda viisi, kuidas me teeme.
And in this next month, there's going to be some pretty big changes, very noticeable changes around here.
Ja järgmisel kuul saad toimuma väga sellised suuremad muutused, sellised märgatavad muutused.
And I don't have everything clear just yet to tell you today, but I'm going to tell you next week.
Mul praegu veel ei ole kõik väga selge, kuidas seda öelda, aga ma räägin sulle tuleval nädalal.
Just the way that things are lining up, it's going to be amazing.
Sellel viisil, kuidas asjad toimuvad, see saab olema midagi väga imelist.
And I think it's going to be very powerful and very positive for our church.
Ja ma usun, et see saab olema väga pääline ja väga positiivne meie koguduse jaoks.
And I believe this is the time for us to make some of these steps that we're going to make.
Ja ma usun, et see saab olema see aeg, et teha need sammud, mida me teeme.
And so as a church, as part of this church,
kogudusena osana selles koguduses,
I need you to hook up with what we're going to be doing.
Mul on vaja seda, et sina haakukid sellega, mida me hakkame tegema.
I want you to be excited. I want you to be expecting.
Ma tahan seda, et sina oleksid põnevil ja et sa oleksid ootuses.
Because we're going to do some things that are going to help us to reach more people in this city.
Kuna me hakkame tegema asju, mis aitavad siis jõuda inimestele siin linnas.
And these things are going to have an impact and a change for the better.
Ja nendel asjadel saab olema selline mõju ja see mõju saab olema paremuse poole.
Some things are always going to remain the same.
Mitte kõik asjad ei jää alati samaks.
We're going to teach the word, baby.
Että on asiat, mis jäävät alati samaksi, on se, että me opettamme sanaa.
Amen. The word of God isn't going to change.
Jumalan sana se ei muuttu.
But how we're doing all that and what all goes in fronts and backs and rounds, it's going to be different.
Aga see, kuidas me siis seda kõike teeme, kuidas see on, kõik need detailid seal, need muutuvad.
So still come back here, still expect the word of God to be fresh and alive for you.
Nii et ikkagi tule siia, oota seda ja Jumala sõna on elav ja värske sinu jaoks.
But I'm believing God to open up the windows of heaven and pour out in this place.
Ma usun seda, et Jumala avab taeva luugid, et ta kallab siia paika.
That there'll be rivers of living water that flow in this place every time we meet.
Et saavad olema need elava vee jõed, mis voolavad siin paigas iga kord, kui me vajame seda.
And more and more people are going to come into this place.
Rohkem inimesi tuleb sellesse paika.
It's going to be awesome. It's going to be amazing. We're going to stand back and just say, God, thank you.
See saab olema imeline, see saab olema hämmastav ja me lihtsalt astume tagasi, ütleme Jumalale aitäh sulle.
By following God, by following his lead.
Läbi Jumala järgimise ja tema juhtimise järgimise.
He'll bless it.
Tema õnnistab seda.
I don't need to make it work.
Mina ei pea seda kuidagi oma jõust panema tööle.
You'll do the job.
Sina teed töö.
He'll do the job through you.
Tema teeb töö läbi sinu.
We just need to give him the place.
Meie lihtsalt peame andma temale selle paiga.
Amen.
Amen.
And so I really want to tell you, but I want to make sure that I tell some other people first.
Ma tahan väga seda rääkida, aga ma tahan teha kindlaks, et ma ennem räägin mõndal teistel inimestel sellest.
Come back next week. I want to reveal what I believe God has for our church.
Tule tagasi järgmisel nädalal ja ma usun, et Jumal tahab ilmutada seda, mis tal on selle koguduse jaoks.
And it's going to be great.
Ja see saab olema vägev.
And it's going to make impact. It's going to be powerful.
Ja see saab avaldama mõju ja see saab olema vägev.
And so I'm excited about
it. Mina olen põnev selle suhtes.
So I just wanted to plant that seed so that you'll be praying and you'll be excited, whatever it is.
Ma tahtsin istutada selle seemne, nii et sa saaksid palvetada ja saaksid olla põneval selle suhtes, mis iganes on siis.
And then as we make these changes, I'm asking you to hook up with us and help us to do it and do it with excellence.
Me teeme need muudatused, siis ma palun sind, et sa haakuksid sellega ja et me siis teeksime seda ja me teeksime seda hästi.
Because I believe anything worth having is worth sharing.
Sest ma usun seda, et kõik see, mis on väärt omamist, on väärt jagamist.
It's worth sharing, right?
Amen.
And if it's worth doing,
ja kui see on väärt tegemist,
do it with excellence.
Siis teha seda väga hästi.
Do it as unto the Lord.
Teha seda otse kui isandale.
Amen.
Amen.